Hi guys, Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome back to Let's Play Conan Exiles. Now, we left off, we had just managed to build ourselves a little bedroll, which I don't have to say isn't exactly a particularly extravagant bed situation. And we had a couple of other things. We had a shaleback egg. Let's eat that up. I did off screen. I did grab a bit of after eating some. I didn't mean to eat that. That wasn't a mistake. Off screen, I did run around and just get myself a little bit of water while I made sure the recording, everything was fine. And I'm going to try and make myself a little bit of clothing here because I don't like being naked. And I think we are encumbered now. I was just looking at the interface here and it says, yeah, look, lightly encumbered. You're carrying enough that your stamina depletes slightly faster. So we're going to want to figure out maybe some way to store our spare stuff. Probably on the cards here. A little bit of plant fiber going on. Yeah, this game is it's a lot of fun. I'm really enjoying. Whoa, okay, no, that was the plant dying. All right, every time something moves in the distance, I think it's a monster coming to kill me. Okay, so we have boots. Also, these are about to break. Repair. Oh, Jesus Christ. Jesus H Christ. No, he hasn't given up. No, still hasn't given up. My God, I need a ranged weapon. All right, looks like he gave up. If we can gather a little bit of gather a little bit of plant fiber. All right, so he's kind of camping our bedroll, which is not good. Play a little bit safe here. See if he's in the area. Doesn't look like it. I'm gonna need a weapon to deal with those. Can I learn? No, I don't have any points available. I need to level up. Does hitting trees get me experience? It does. So let's hit trees a little bit. Though I don't want to get too encumbered. What was I making? Right, I was actually trying to repair my gear. So I'm gonna repair my stuff. And then I'm also gonna craft this. Can't repair this, oddly, huh? So I'm crafting a coarse tunic. I did want to make a sword. Whoa, so I need more plant fiber to make that sword. That's the goal right now, is I need a sword. And I look at him, there he is running around over there making my life difficult. Okay, I think it's safe here to go harvesting a little bit. See, yeah, we're making, I'm gonna keep him in vision range if possible. There he is. He shouldn't aggro if I keep distance. At least that's what I'm hoping. Okay, so we're now fully equipped. We need some twine. I need 10, which means I need 30 of this plant fiber. Okay, he made a noise, but it wasn't an angry noise. It was just a general noise. Once we have a sword, well, I'm going to want to make a shield, actually, too. Let's see here. Okay, I have enough plant fiber now to make the 10 twine I need. We're going to keep grabbing this plant fiber because it seems pretty useful. Oh, I heard an animal noise. Nope, never mind, I'm fine. And the game is really fun. I can't wait to go exploring. I don't know if I'll probably spend a bit of time in this series not really exploring much and just kind of building up to a certain point. Oop, did not mean to do that. There's also some dudes over there I wanted to fight. Now, let's get this sword. Excellent, we've got a sword coming. Grabbing some of these plant fibers. Huh. Is that it? Okay, yeah, that's it. Okay, we've pretty much cleared this area out of plant fibers. What do I need for a shield? I need 8 twine. My God, that's expensive. Can I make... I haven't leveled up yet. Not quite yet. There's an imp over there. There's that guy who attacked me. Let's play it safe here. We're not going to go too close to him because he seems to want to attack me a lot. Okay, looks like I've aggroed the imp, which is what I wanted. I wanted to fight this guy for experience. What am I using this for? Should I use this sword? Ah, well, that was a dumbass move of me. Okay, so I got some flesh off this guy. Didn't quite get me a level up, but maybe hitting the rock a little will. Oh, there goes my pickaxe. Doesn't seem to be leveling me up. Is leveling just passive? Okay, there we go. We got a level. Can I build like a storage thing? So here is a campfire that could be useful for cooking food. I think I'm gonna get the campfire because I want to cook. But what do I need for that? I need 50 branches. That's gonna be a lot of tree chopping. Let me tell ya. Anything here I can dump? Let's drop that. I got some grubs I can eat. I'm gonna eat the hell out of them. I got herbs. Aloe leaves, so it's a medicinal plant. Combustible low grade. Alright, let's chop some trees. I'm mainly looking for branches though. Okay, I got no branches from that. What about a pickaxe? Nope. I guess we gotta go looking for branches the old-fashioned way. Let's see. Is there anything in my inventory I can kind of just get rid of? Bone isn't really useful to me right now. Seeds are pretty light. Oh, I have a level up, actually. I can put a point into encumbrance. Yeah, then a point in encumbrance may be a lot lighter. I don't see this feral flesh as super useful. I'm going to throw some away. It's not very heavy either, though. That's my problem. You can make a torch. Vitals. Okay. I do need food. That's kind of a problem right now. I'm trying to think of how do I get branches. Oh, do you know what there was? There were some people to fight over here. Do I have enough plant fiber to make a shield? 8. Let's go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I'm gonna make a shield. And there were some people. Yeah, there they are. They're over there. Let's see if I can kill them. And then craft the shield. So what does this actually do? Small length of twine. It doesn't seem to do anything. There's my character in his glory. Come on, shield. Oh, geez. Oh, okay. That was my own character making noises. Oh, man. I heard noises and I thought it was something coming to kill me. So if I press 5, yeah, it'll open both and I can right click and left click. All right, nice. So I should be able to... Wait, who's aggroing me? Who's aggroing me? What's fighting me? Oh, it's this guy. Block, hit, hit. Block, hit. Excellent. Let me give me your meat. Although that really screwed up my shield. Can I aggro one of these at a time? Make my way over slowly. Okay, I got two of them. That's not what I was hoping for. Okay, let's hope I can kill one. Come on. Come on. Come on. Die. Oh my god. Okay, okay, you had stone on you. You had plant fiber on you. Excellent. Can I harvest your corpses? Human flesh, ay. Is this edible? I really, you know, probably is. Not sure I want to eat it though. Well, let's eat a little bit. Yeah, okay. Let's not eat that. What does food poisoning do? I guess my guy's a cannibal now. There's another dude over there that I want to kill. I'm going to wait till my health regenerates a little bit, though. Oh, I may as well gather some sticks around here while I wait, because there is quite a few. Or branches, actually, because I'm trying to make a campfire, because I want to, cook this food. See if I can not starve and oh, I actually have water. Let me drink up here. Yeah. Fully hydrated is nice. One thing I really like about this game is what they do is when you get to full hydration or hunger, it lets you stay at full hydration and hunger for a little while. That's one of my favorite things actually so far. A lot of games, it's like you get to full hunger and then it like slowly starts ticking down right away. I really like that they just made it. You get to full hunger, you stay there for a bit. I'm gonna repair my gear. Keep my stuff in order. Okay, we're paired up. I could make a water skin. I do need sticks. How many sticks do I have? I'm halfway. Am I not recovering health? I guess I don't have enough food. Bit of a dilemma here. I'm not strong enough to fight him without a campfire food. So let's go gather some sticks. There was lots of sticks around here. So maybe if I just skirt the edges of these guys, look for sticks on the ground like here. I'm also getting pretty encumbered, so I'm going to want somewhere to put my stuff eventually. Nice. Oh, I could steal some eggs. That would actually deal with my hunger pretty well. Excuse me, thank you. Sorry. Very sorry. I need this more than you. Very nice. I should recover health quicker now. No, I have food poisoning. It's going to slow it down probably. Pick up these things. Did I actually repair? I did repair my clothing at least. Okay, so I have 40 branches out of the 50 I need. Let's keep grabbing. More branches? Come on. Oh, there's a bad guy. Don't want to get too close to him. He might mistake me for dinner. Oh, wow. Food poisoning is a really bad debuff. I really never want to get it again. Okay, so I'm next level encumbered. My stamina depletes faster. Okay, so it doesn't affect your actual movement speed, which I like. I've never really liked it when games affect your movement speed. I prefer the stamina drain thing. Like it feels more... I don't know, it just feels more intuitive to me and this is bad. What's aggroed me? Okay, it's just a little dude. Three hits. Okay, he should go down. Should harvest him too. Okay, there we go. Do I have a charge attack on this? No, you just hold it. Okay, branch. How many more? One more branch. And then I can make a campfire and cook food. One more branch. Come on. That's a rock. Wait, I thought my bed was over here. Did I trick myself? No, it's here. Okay. One more branch. Come on. Give it to me. Yes. Okay, we have it. Get over here. Craft this campfire. I'm gonna stick it down here. See if I can get rid of these rocks actually. Make a nice little base area for myself. I'm like a nomad. Okay. Six. What? This little campfire? I thought it was gonna be this huge thing. It's a little shitty campfire. Alright, I'll put it there. Open. I want to burn some wood. Can I cook meat? Oh, here on the right side. Okay, so... we are... So you can't actually cook human flesh, it seems, but you can cook this feral stuff. So I'm just gonna drop this on the ground. Drop. I don't want it. Take all. Oh no. Give. 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 I wonder what else can be put in here. Probably just a few things. Okay, so can I eat this now? And it not hurt me? Yeah, there we go. Cooked food. All right, we're doing it, guys. Let's get some water, too. Need a little bit more food. All right, we're surviving. Putrid meat. Can that be cooked? Nope. That's also going to be dropped on the ground. Let me loot bag. Drop you in there. Not allowed to place items in that. All right. And drop some meat on the ground. I want to clear this. There we go. Sword. Go back up into my... Thank you. Now go there and there. Open campfire. Nice, I should be able to eat that. Alright, we're full. We're full on hunger and thirst. I'm going to wait through here while this cooks. Because I think it lasts longer if it's cooked. Yeah, it seems like it. We haven't leveled up from this. So we're probably going to want to start gathering a bunch of stones and stuff. Well, let's have a look here. What do we need? We pretty much have everything we need, so it's more or less exploration and fighting we're going to be doing. Hey, what's up, Impy? More meat. Give me your meat. Not like that. Although he actually, I think if you look, he does have a little penis. Which, you know, not exactly the kind of content I want to be showing on my channel. Not ideal. So, it seems like hitting rocks doesn't get you much. It seems like the best way to level up is to kill things. So, I'm going to try and take on one of those guys that keeps attacking me. Now, I feel like with a sword and full food and hunger and stuff like that, I think we've got a real chance. I think we'll just let that keep burning away. So, there was one around here. Here's one. This is just a little baby. I'll kill you. I don't want wood, I want the baby. Let me hit him. Oh, here we go. All right, this is the guy. This is the fight. Come here, buddy. 3, 4. Ow. All right, he hurts. But I have a sword. Ow, that hurt. Okay, we did it. We got him. Woo! Damn. Give me your meat. Savory flesh. Bones. That's it. Wow, that was definitely not worth it. out of stamina. Okay, let's repair all our stuff. Repair. 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 Okay, have we cooked all the meat yet? Almost. We got a little bit more. Cook the savory flesh too. So this cooked meat should do a lot for us. It's gonna help us survive in the wilderness. I'm waiting for this meat to cook. Alright, here comes the good meat. The grilled steaks. The steak, the shale back. I guess we could use more stones, although I don't know what for. I guess our tools are expensive in stones. We're going to kind of deplete the resources in the area. I've always wanted the idea, like, here's my idea for a perfect survival open world game, like for a competitive. Oh, I found ironstone. Whoa. Cool. Anyway, here's like my theory of an awesome open world game. It's that everyone starts in the same world, right? But the resources are finite, and you go through and it plays like a normal survival game. It would just be like, you know, Rust or Ark or even this game or any other game you can think of. and you go through the round, you go through and you play, but the resources are finite. So if, you know, once you mine out a rock, that rock is just gone. And so it's slowly over time, the game, you know, at the beginning, there's like this abundance and everyone can afford to survive on the world. But then as the game progresses, like the number of animals in the world decreases, the number of trees in the world decreases. So it becomes like a late game survival battle, like fight over resources. I don't know, maybe that's dumb, but I think that sounds like really cool. So I'm kind of just looking to level up now. So let's go run around and kill some stuff. Can I repair this pickaxe? All right, here's an enemy. Let's kill this. We've already fought one of these, but let's fight another one. Ouch. Alright, die, you piece of shit. Ow, what the hell? Alright, we got him. Alright, we got some stuff off him. He didn't hurt too bad. Oh, there's loot on the ground. I want to take it easy on my encumbrance here. In case I need to run away from something. My health regenerate a little bit. I think taking melee damage really helped, actually. Nice. All right, let's keep going. Plant fibers, handful of insects. Excellent, excellent. We're surviving. See if we can't eat those insects, actually, just to top up our hunger. And have a sip of the water, too, to keep that topped up. Alright, here's a deer. Can I kill a deer with a sword? This would be really nice. 2, 3, 4. No! Yes! I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna do it! Die! Alright, I got him. Give me all that meat, all that hide and flesh and bone. Alright, we're about to level up. So let's make our way back to our base. Well, I guess, is it a base or is it just like a little camp? So experience, is there a way to see? No, it doesn't seem to be a way to see how much experience you need. And it, okay, so I've confirmed that experience is passive also, like the longer you're alive the more you get, which is cool. I like that. Let's sneak back here and have a look at our upgrades. So we have a level up here. I liked actually getting the encumbrance. Oh, here's experience. Oh yeah, you get a few experience per second. No, it's every few seconds you get an experience. Okay. I like the idea of getting some more encumbrance. So now we're up to 84. Okay, we could become an archer. We could become a brute. We could get a torch. We could get a wooden box. That would be really useful, but I think I'm going to start building a house. So let's unlock this. And all right, let's have a look for a location of the house. I like an idea of a little waterfront property myself, although tucked into a wall would be nice too. I think around here is actually a really good... Oh Jesus Christ, you came out of nowhere. Oh, you demon turtle. All right, we got him. The mobs, they just come out of nowhere and scare the crap out of you. Okay, can we craft this? What does it take? Oh, it takes wood. I need wood. Okay, we got some wood. Sorry, I'm actually a 12-year-old boy laughing at that. I'm gonna craft this. I'm gonna do like a 5x5. That sounds like a good... Oh, a little bit of a laggy when you first load in a new item. So, okay. I'm just pressing buttons, so mouse wheel rotates it, shift mouse wheel brings it up and down, control mouse wheel does nothing, control mouse wheel zooms me in, oddly. Now, the question is, do I want to be really high off the ground, or do I want to be really low off the ground? I tell you what, let's go like a moderate, like here's low. And here's high. Let's go moderately off the ground. Here's a moderately. Let's make another one. Cool. We made a little thing. I'm proud of this. And I've only just placed one block. There we go. We'll place two. Let's make another one. Let's Keep getting wood. Finally getting a chance to use up all this stone and another one. Oh, not enough resources. So what do I lack? Oh, wow. It takes a lot of stone. Well, let's get stone hitting. Maybe a 5x5 was ambitious, but I think I'm going to stick with 5x5 because that's what I said. Hi ho, hi ho, it's off to work we go. Maybe 5 is too much. Yeah, 5 maybe too much. Let's do a 3x3. 3x3 seems reasonable for one person to pull off. Hitting the stones, let's do it. Whoa, what was that? Oh, it was just a little graphical effect. I really like the idea of repairing. I've never liked it in games when, like, if an item breaks, you just have to make a whole new one. That's something that really bothered me. Let's see here. Wow, that's a lot of stone. Ooh, found a fat grub. Let me eat that. Oh, I leveled up. Oh. Huh. I don't want to learn torch because I think I already have torch. Oh, this is an improvised torch. This is it, and there's an improved version. Okay. Whoa. Oh, I didn't mean to reset attributes. Whoops. 2 levels of encumbrance, 3 levels of strength. Huh? How come it says 77? That should say 87. 84, I mean. Oh, well. I don't know. I think I clicked the button there by accident that I shouldn't have. All right, let's get chopping. Chopping, I guess. Picking? Mining? Is this mining? I don't think this counts as mining. I'm more gathering. Dude, I really love the way the stones die. It's actually so cool. Okay, made another one. I think I want to be at about 150 stone. Awesome. The way the stones break is really nice. Make a new one. Or I guess it's repairing, not making a new one. Like I said there a few moments ago. Okay, I should have enough now. To here. Not enough resources. What do I lack? A wood. Oh. Choppy chop. Nice. Whoa, what is that? Oh, it's a plant. Jesus Christ. Everything in this game just scares the crap out of me. I'm like traumatized. All these monsters coming at me and stuff. Alright, should be enough now to finish this off. At least the foundation part. Not enough resources. What do I lack? Oh, I need more stone. Thankfully, there's a lot of stone around here. Although I'm worried I might deplete all the resources in the area, which is kind of what brought me to talk about that whole idea of a game where the resources deplete over time. Because I did play a game kind of like that once, and it was a lot of fun. Because in the late game, you were basically fighting over dirt. And, you know, whoever had managed to hoard a bit of stone was in really good shape. Okay. Make our way over here. Try and do a little bit of stuff on the way. This should be the last one I need. Okay, so we've got the foundation of our base laid down. I feel like we've got a good little thing going on here. We'll be able to build a little base and then explore over there, for example. I'd like to explore over there. But that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what your thoughts are. If you want to see more episodes of Conan Exiles, make sure you subscribe to the channel. If you want to directly support my channel, make sure you leave a like on the video. And if you want to give me direct feedback on this episode, make sure you leave me a comment. But that's it from me. I hope you guys had a fun time watching this. I know I'm having a fun playing it. See ya. Bye.